In movies, people jump into water to dodge bullets and hide from enemies. Although it may seem intuitive, because people can't be seen clearly underwater, today we're going to talk about the physics of bullets, and by the end of the video, you will know what determines if they can kill underwater. When a bullet leaves the barrel, projectile motion begins and gravity acts on the bullet to pull it downward. Although high school physics tends to ignore air resistance,
We don't do that here.
It is actually very important in determining the range of the bullet as well as the speed of the impact. This is especially true when air is replaced by water that is 800 times denser, which makes the drag force 800 times greater as well. However, in Saving Private Ryan, we can see Allied soldiers being shot by Germans' heavy machine guns even after jumping into the sea. Is it because the bullets are too fast, or is the scene simply inaccurate?
You are wrong! All of you are wrong!
To test the scientific accuracy, the Smithsonian Channel experimented with a rifle that is the modern equivalent of the German weapon during D-Day, shooting a 7.62mm bullet at over 2,700 feet per second. The result was shocking because the bullet couldn't even hit the target at point-blank range, what is an extremely short distance where a bullet drop due to gravity is negligible. As the bullet entered the water at supersonic speed, what happened was that the shockwave created a low pressure behind the bullet, which dragged it backward and made it tumble. That is known as pressure drag, and is one of the two major drag forces that constitutes what we call fluid resistance. This isn't actually the first time experts tried to shoot bullets into water. In fact, early on Discovery Channel, the MythBusters already tested out using a variety of weapons ranging from pistols to rifles, and the results were rather surprising as well. To dodge bullets from rifles up to 50 calibers, you only need to stay 3 feet underwater because the bullets can't even reach you, let alone kill you. Instead of tumbling and coming to a full stop, what happened to the bullets was even worse. They disintegrated into tiny fragments because water resistance was simply too large. That is especially the case for the 50 caliber that travels at 3,000 feet per second because the drag is directly proportional to the square of speed. The faster the bullet travels in air, the greater the resistance it gets in water. This shows that high-speed bullets from rifles and machine guns shouldn't be able to hit deep underwater, but doesn't mean a slower bullet can do the job. Well, according to the MythBusters, slower bullets fired by pistols can indeed get deeper into the water. Even if you stay 8 feet underwater, you can still be hit by pistol, even though it won't be a lethal shot. This proves that slower bullets have higher penetrative power in water. And among all weapons, shotguns seem to be the most powerful, because not only did it puncture the ballistic gel at a depth of 8 feet, it even ruptured the tank they used for experiment. Although they didn't explain the phenomenon, my guess is that a shotgun slug is more massive, thus it contains more kinetic energy despite a lower speed. So far, we know water is sort of bulletproof, but it still depends on the speed and type of the bullet. While shotgun slug seems to be the only lethal ammo underwater because it is massive but slow enough to lower water resistance, what if I tell you there's a new kind of bullet that can ignore water drag and still travel at a high speed underwater? Well, in the next video, we're going to introduce a supercavitating bullet called Calvex and explain the physics behind it.